In this video, we'll be looking at how to calculate exponential moving average using Excel. So in the earlier video, we have looked at simple moving average. Then already we have a moving average. Then what is the need of another moving average called exponential moving average? So the problem with simple moving average was that equal weightage was assigned to all the observations. Let's say you have 10 observations, so 10 closing prices. So for all the prices, you are assigning equal weightage. What is the formula for simple moving average? Closing price of all the days until C10, then you will divide it by 10. So we are talking about 10 period simple moving average. So here the other way to write this is C1 divided by 10 plus C2 divided by 10 and so on until C10 divided by 10. So I can say that 1 by 10th weightage is given to each closing price here. So the problem with this is even the historical value and the latest value, both of them are being assigned same weightage. Because of this, a lag is being created. So lag in the sense, the distance between the price and the simple moving average is large, because of which the price does not react faster. Simple moving average, it does not react faster to the price movements. So whatever the alert that you're going to get based on this simple moving average, it will be a bit delayed. So after the story has already happened, then you might get an alert. So which is of no use to us. To reduce this lag, what we need to do is we'll need to give highest weightage to the latest observation and least weightage to the historical observation. Now, exponential moving average, it carries the same concept. Here, a new concept called multiplier is introduced, and this multiplier, what it does is it gives highest weightage to the latest observation. That means if I'm taking 10 period exponential moving average, yesterday's data will be given the highest weightage and the first data will be given the least weightage. So this is the formula for exponential moving average, and this indicator has come into light because it reduces the lag which simple moving average was producing. So this exponential moving average, it reacts faster to the price movement. Now let's see the calculation. Now this is the formula. So if I'm taking 10 period exponential moving average, that means the first 10 observations, it will not have any exponential moving average. On the 11th day, for the first time, you won't have any exponential moving average. So what we'll do is on the 11th day, we'll take the simple moving average itself. And then that simple moving average will substitute in the formula for EMA. Then on 11th day, you'll be getting certain EMA, because the exponential moving average, it depends on EMA of yesterday. Now, for the very first time, if you don't have EMA itself, then what will you write in this place? So in this place, we'll substitute it with simple moving average for the very first time. And following that, every day, the previous day's EMA will be substituted here. When we see the Excel sheet, it will be clear to you. So just see the formula here. Exponential moving average is close price, that means today's close price minus yesterday's EMA. This whole thing you multiply it with multiplier. Multiplier is nothing but 2 divided by the look back period which you are going to supply. Now in this case, the time period is equal to 10 because I'm taking 10 day EMA. So time period is equal to 10. So close minus yesterday's EMA whole multiplied by the multiplier. And the multiplier is equal to 2 divided by n plus 1. N is equal to 10 in our case. And this whole thing, it is added to yesterday's EMA again. Now for the 11th observation, we don't have an EMA, so we'll be substituting SMA for that case. Let's move on to the Excel sheet now, so things will get clearer to you. So this is the historical data available with me. Now out of this, open date, open high low is of no use to me. What's more useful to me is the close price. Now 10-day EMA is what I want here, and I have the closing price of first 10 days. Now the formula for exponential moving average is today's close price minus previous day EMA, and this whole thing you are going to multiply it with multiplier. Again, you add the whole thing to previous day EMA. So this is the formula for exponential moving average. First thing, what we need is previous day's EMA. Closing price we already have. On the 11th day, you have a closing price. So that is available with us now. And multiplier is also available to us. So this is the multiplier. 2 divided by 10 plus 1, which is nothing but 0.18. So we have close price and we have multiplier. Now what we need is previous day's EMA. Now since we are calculating it for the first time, we'll not have previous day's EMA with us. So what we'll do is, in place of previous day's EMA for the first observation, we'll take the simple moving average of all these 10 days, and on the 11th day we'll just have a simple moving average, we'll not have EMA. Now from 12th day onwards, in this formula I'll substitute the simple moving average, so I'll get an EMA for 12th day. Now starting from 13th day, since I have the EMA of previous day, that will not be any problem. So let me do it manually now. Now it is 10 day EMA, so starting 10 days, this is the starting 10 days. On 10th day I'll not have an EMA, so I'll just calculate the simple moving average, average of starting 10 days. I have the value. Now this itself is an EMA for me. This is not simple moving average for me. I'll consider this as exponential moving average. Now on this day, to calculate the EMA of that particular day, what I'll need? First, I'll need the close price of that day. I have that. Minus previous day's EMA. I'll multiply it by the multiplier, and this whole thing you need to add it with the previous day's EMA. So again, previous day's EMA for me is this itself. So on this particular day I have one more EMA. Next day again it starts the same, close price, close price minus previous day's EMA into multiplier, this whole thing, add the previous day's EMA again. So starting from this observation, you will be having previous day's EMA, but for the first observation you don't have a previous day EMA, so that's the reason you will take the simple moving average, and on 12th day, in place of the previous day EMA, we'll substitute previous day SMA. And from 13th day, everything will be normal because you have an EMA for 12th day. So that you will be substituting here. Now just select this and click on this black dot, double click on that, and you will have the, yeah, so the problem here is the multiplier, it should be made constant. So this is the multiplier here. So that will be made constant. And if I just double click on that, so this is your exponential moving average. So select the exponential moving average, go to insert, plot a line. You have your exponential moving average here. If you want date on the x-axis, right click on it, select the data, and in the horizontal axis, you need to choose the date. So this is your exponential moving average. The difference in the calculation for simple moving average and exponential moving average is that the formula itself is different. You are depending upon exponential moving average of the previous day. For the 10th day, you don't have an EMA, so you'll calculate the SMA. On 11th day, you don't have EMA of previous day, so you'll substitute the previous day's SMA into this. And from 12th day onwards, calculation will be simple. So this is your exponential moving average.